Hi everyone, this is a tutorial for SimCity 3000 Unlimited. It can be confusing at first to play this game because somehow the developers assume that you played the previous editions, and if you didn't, like me, the first time when I played this, it took me a few hours, I'm gonna lie, few hours to learn the game. Let's go and get started. So that you know, you actually have a tutorial available. You just have to know where to look for it. If you go to load city and select tutorial, this is the tutorial for the game. You can try this one if it's convenient for you. We go to start new city. We give it a name. Mayor's name, I already have it. The difficulty level and start date, I will leave it by default. You can choose disaster if you want it a bit more challenging. Now, we choose the terrain. I will accept. Now, I will make adjustments. I'll give it more plain. Okay, this one. You can level the terrain if you want. I will do this now to make it a bit more easy for this tutorial. But you know, you can leave it by default. You just drag across a surface and it will be leveled. Accept. These are the starting tips. Some of them can be useful. To start, you need three zones. You go to this build transportation tab. We select roads. I will zoom in even more to get an idea of the scale of things. You may want to start small, not big, because it costs money and you can run out of them pretty quick. How I said, three zones delimited by roads for machines to go one place from another. You need roads. You go to zones, which is like residential. You click and drag commercial, light commercial, click and drag, and industrial, light industrial. You may want to start with light because the demand for a specific zone is for light at the beginning, and the changes along the way. Also, the demand is for residential, industrial more than commercial at first. Now, you also need two main things. One of them is power. I will choose power plants, coal and oil. Oil is more expensive, but somehow better. I'll choose this one. I will build it here, right on the edge, the border with my neighbor. The starting tips say that if you build a polluting building right on the border with your neighbor, half of the pollution goes to your neighbor. Not very nice of us, but it gets the job done. Now go to power lines and connect it to your city. Now you need a water structure. I will choose pumping station, it's better than water tower. You place it next to a water source. I'll put it here. Now you select water pipes, and now you have the underground view. And you go with it to your city. You can choose whatever route you want. For the long run, it may be easier if you build it underneath the roads. A water pipes water 7 tiles, one side and another. So one water pipes in the middle, it will be enough. But how I said, it may be proven easier to track how your city is watered along the way if you build it underneath the roads. To go back to the surface, you click a surface structure like power lines, and now you have to connect your pumping station with power lines to receive power. This is it. This is the basics. It is quite simple and easy. You need 3 zones, you need power, and you need water. Now, how we can see the game is paused to give you time to build things. I'll run the simulation. It will take some time for the game to update itself. This button is to query different things. If I choose now the pumping station, you can see it's powered. It's not powered. The same for the tires. Powered, watered, now. If you've done everything right, they will be soon. Another thing you may want to build a landfill. You need roads to it. I'll do it like this. You drag a road right on the edge with your neighbor. It asks you if you want to make a connection to your neighbor. I'll choose it yes on this time. You go to zone and you choose landfill. This is for garbage disposal. A small zone like this with only 7 tiles is enough at first. I will increase the speed and soon we will see the first buildings. From now on it's pretty easy, you just have to listen to your advisors. We already have the first buildings. We query now, we see pumping stations powered. This is used 50 ohm. And the tiles is powered and watered. If you go to the underground view, click on the water pipes, you can see it watered, which zone is watered and which not. Alright. This is it. This is the basics of the game. Next, what you can do is to, how I said, listen to your advisor. If you click on the meet button, you have your advisors. It will give you advices like commercial taxes to load, to increase them. If you choose briefings, it will teach you about different things, each and every one of them. Now about the interface of the game, just a bit. This is the name of the city. This population, 0 for now. The money you have and the date. This with greens are the news. It's presented like news, but are advices from your advisors. This is to pause the simulation, play the simulation, the speed of the game. You have to click it to query a building. This is the indicator for the zones. which is in demand and when, residential, commercial and industrial. This will also vary along the way. You can see it high for a specific amount of time, after which it can come down and up again. Don't worry about it too much. It would only give you a general idea on what zone is more demanded from another. The first one is landscape. You can level terrain, lower it, raise it, zones, residential, commercial, industrial, landfill, and seaport, airport. This is for later in the game, and demolish. Transportation, roads are the basics. Highway, it's more expensive. Bus stop is for internal transportation. Mass transit, this is the same. On each and every one you have demolish option. Utilities, power lines, power plants, water pipes, water structures, garbage disposal. This is for garbage, like landfill, more advanced. Here you have city civic buildings like police, fire station and so on. This is for emergencies, advisors. Here you have a budget to look over your finances, your neighbors. You have four of them. Ordinances, you'll learn about it. And of course, data screen. Here you can learn about different statistics of your city, like crime, and how I said, pollution. How you can see the pollution here, half of them is towards our neighbor. Okay, also please remember to put buildings that pollute away from your city. You don't want to place it near a residential area. Your Sims won't like it too much. Okay, this is it. How I said, here I will cover only the basics. If you find it useful, you can tell me about it. If you want a bit more advanced tutorial, please let me know in the messages. And also don't forget to subscribe and even like the video to let other users know if this is a good tutorial or not. Okay, have fun.